today, the Giants are a miserable 2-13, and now they're calling each other out in the media. Yesterday, safety Landon Collins called Eli Apple a, quote, cancer during an appearance on ESPN Radio. Apple was benched early in the season for disciplinary reasons. Shannon, what's your take?
Skip, I haven't played as long as I played, and I spoke a lot. Basically, I was the official and unofficial spokesman of the team. But when I was describing players current that I was playing with or former, I was very cautious in the words that I chose.
Yep.
I know two words you can't use in describing a player unless you better mean them, and they better be true. Mm-hmm. Quitter, you can't call a teammate, former or current, a quitter, and you can't say he's a cancer. Mm. It's hard for me to believe if Landon Collins went to this length to call him a cancer, I bet you there are three or four other guys in that locker room feel the very same way. This is not normal for a guy to call a current teammate a cancer.
Yep.
Something is going on. I would not be surprised if they tried to move on from him, be a trade or whatever they have to do. But Landon Collins, his body of work and his reputation speak for himself. I don't know Eli Apple. I don't really know Landon Collins. But for him to go to this length, to say what he said about this young man, that's not normal, Skip.
And I do consider Landon Collins the leader of that secondary because he's clearly the, I guess he's the best. Well, Janoris is pretty good, too. But I'm with you, and yet here came this kid. He was the 10th pick in the draft.
Yes.
With the name Eli Apple, like Eli Manning, Big Apple. It's like, it's almost like a made-up name.
Right.
And his mom, remember, Annie had become an internet presence, and then she got a TV gig, and there was a little LeVar going on,
training
just a little bit, you know, like a little bit of it built expectations around this kid, and it was hard for him to live up to it. And when you go 2-13, you've never gone through that before, but I've seen teams lose 13 games, it becomes a quagmire in the locker room. Nothing is right, and fingers are pointed, and now everybody's pointing fingers at this kid, and I'm sure there's some legitimacy to it.
Losing reveals more character than winning ever does, because then you'll find out who's serious about the game and their job. Skip, this is not normal for you to call a current player, a member of your team, a cancer. Something is serious.